We're going to clean some parts from a French clock I'm working on. You'll notice I'm wearing gloves because these parts have already been cleaned and polished. So now we're going to put them into the ultrasonic and give them a final cleaning there. First up, I'll put this small part into this mesh container so it can't get lost in the bottom of the ultrasonic cleaner. Then we'll get the basket from the ultrasonic cleaner and put the parts into it. When you're using ultrasonic cleaner, make sure that when you put the parts in, they're separate from each other. Don't lie them flat one on top of another or they won't clean properly. We'll put the little basket in. Then over to the ultrasonic, put the basket in. Turn it on. Adjust the temperature up to 30 degrees. Press the button for 5 minutes. We'll remove the basket with the parts in them. Now we'll take them outside and wash them. We'll now wash the ultrasonic fluid off our parts. Yeah, this is so ground. Clean some of it out. Splash water on it again. And we'll transfer the parts to another tray with clean water in it. Remember, we're wearing gloves all the time because these parts have been polished and cleaned in the ultrasonic. Any finger marks on the parts will leave a permanent mark. We'll move the parts around a little bit to wash the fluid off them. Then we'll put them in another tub with Shellite. The Shellite will displace the water. We'll let them soak there for a couple of minutes. Once they're all in there, then we'll take them out, put them on a piece of acid-free paper. If you use anything but acid-free paper, a piece of cloth or newspaper or anything else, you will leave marks on your final product. Must be acid-free paper. From now on, every part will have to be handled with gloves. The final part of the cleaning, we'll use a hairdryer to heat and remove the shellite from each part. Doesn't need much heat. to evaporate the shell off. Dry each piece off in turn, making sure that we don't overheat the pieces. Right, now we can take them back to the bench and start to assemble the movement.